Hi there. My name is Virginia Crow. And before I talk to you about my recent experience at a corporate pouring party event, I just wanted to introduce myself really quick and just give you a brief background on why I'm here and who I am. So basically, last year I decided to sell my gym and change careers. And at the time, I didn't really know what that was going to be. I just knew that I couldn't sustain the lifestyle I was trying to live and the hours I needed to put into the business of the gym. I had three other partners, and I really just wasn't able to pull my weight as a partner. And I knew that I wouldn't be able to sustain it for a long period of time. So, because of my age and my son being autistic and a teenager, I just felt the need to really try to find a different career path and figure something else out. And I really had no idea what that was going to be at the time. I had been through a lot of trauma in my life and some abuse, and I just needed to take some time for myself and figure it out. So I did just that. I sold my gym, and about 3 months after the sale, I kind of just took the advice of some of my family members. I do have an artistic gene in my family, but I wouldn't say that I really personally explored it very much. I went through a few times where I designed some t-shirts and did some other things, but I don't think I really put my whole heart into it. So in the summer of 2018, I really just started to explore drawing. And that morphed into painting and taking online video courses, YouTube video tutorials, stuff like that, which led me to the acrylic pouring community, which I had a blast doing. I have to say that in my family and, owning my own gym, I think naturally have an entrepreneurial spirit and don't really like working for other people. So it just felt really natural for me to go into the acrylic pouring party scene and see if I could do that. I had been to a lot of paint and wine nights and that sort of thing, but I thought, how cool would it be to take this acrylic pouring to somebody's home or on location somewhere and teach a lot of people how to do this. Through a lot of trial and error and some very messy parties, I really do feel like I've come up with a very cool system that keeps everything clean, and it's really, really easy to set up for. I've made checklists and I've made these little kits that I prepare ahead of time for my parties so that I literally can get to a party and, throw some tablecloths on the tables that they provide and make the setup really, really quick. And then, also through trial and error, I have really narrowed down my teaching style and the way that I need to deliver the instructions so that everybody gets a really nice result. I've had so much fun recently with the larger parties that I've been throwing. So I think my largest party at this point has been about 30 people. I just did one yesterday that was 23, and it was at a corporation. One of my art clients is the president of this company, and she hired me to come in and do like a lunch and learn type event for her staff. And she felt like they really needed a creative outlet. So I went to them and set up on the rooftop of their building, which was very windy. And I delivered a really cool experience for them. And I'm getting some really great feedback. I did send out a SurveyMonkey survey, and all of the comments are great. I'm not getting really any feedback that's negative except for the wind. And there was nothing we could really do about that because all of the conference rooms were taken up and the offices themselves were really small. So we did our best in the situation, but everybody was very, very happy. So what I've done recently is I've put together an online course to help you understand how I do what I do. And I wanted it to include everything from, you know, an example of me teaching. So yesterday I actually had some people film me going through the demonstration process and put it, I put that video into the course. I video the exact setup and what I use in each of my kits and what I do ahead of time. I've included all of the different PDF documents that you would need to use prior to your party. So everything that you should do ahead of time, and then a checklist of everything that you need to bring with you. I've also included the cheat sheet that I put on the table so that while the participants are listening to me do the instructions, they can follow along the cheat sheet. And then that just kind of gives me a little bit of assistance, especially with the larger groups, on answering questions. So the thing that I find, if I don't have an assistant with me to help me facilitate questions, I have a lot of the Virginia, 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 come over here, you know, type of a thing. However, the way that I'm delivering my instructions at this point has really reduced those questions. So I think that just comes over time. But the actual cheat sheet just helps people have something to follow along and refer to if they do have a question while, you know, the actual event is happening. So yesterday we did a 4x4 tile. We did an 8x10 canvas. We did the tile first. And I noticed the one thing that I did was I didn't measure out how much paint to pouring medium ratio to actually give their instructions. I just had the paint to pouring medium ratio for the 8x10 canvas. So that's something that I'll change for next time. I'll do some experimentation at home for a 4x4 tile. But I just wanted to give them a little bit more to take home with them because I had a little extra time than I thought I had. So I just threw the 4x4 tile in there. So if you were to purchase this course and watch that video, you'll see that, you know, there was a little bit of extra paint that spilled over the tiles that wasn't necessarily needed, and some might consider it wasteful, but you live and learn and you move forward, and it didn't create a bad experience for them, so I'm okay with that. So in the course, I have all of those downloadable forms, and it's something that, you know, you can follow and create your own forms from and your own checklists. I also include an aftercare sheet. You'll see that the way that my kit is, it's easy to transport home. They were able to actually leave their paintings at their offices overnight so that they can dry, or 2 days, however long they needed to dry. But for those parties that people actually need to take things home with them, this kit provides a really clean and safe way for those paintings to travel home. They're kind of locked into these little pans that I use. They're covered with tin foil. There's an aftercare instruction sheet on top so that they know what to do with their paintings after they've cured, how long to wait for them to cure, and all of that stuff. And then the course also includes kind of a step-by-step on how I started marketing myself and, you know, what I did to feel confident about actually teaching my first party. So if you're interested in learning a little bit more about my process, go ahead and click on the link that's included in this blog, and it'll take you to that course and you can see the details of what I do. But I also include in this video just some pictures of some of my student works. I hope you enjoy that, and some pictures of the parties. And I look forward to possibly working with you. Reach out if you have any questions. I'd love to answer them, and have a great day.